All right, now we're at the upper echelon, the top teams, the toppy, the tippy, the top. I don't know. Anyway, for this NBA offseason, free agency, collab, whatever you want to say, for the Eastern Western Conference, I was like, we're at the very top. We at the one that we might think, like, hey, one move, maybe they could be, maybe they not. I don't know. I'm already go ahead and get out the way. Boston, I don't have nothing to say about them. They won the championship. I was like, unless they trade somebody or whatever, like, you know, like Pritchard and get like some other stuff, something like that. Look, they ain't nothing to do. They got they five, they got they six, seven dudes. They're pretty much good. I was like, the Knicks, they done added OG Anunoby along with Mikal Bridges. I was like, I really think they're pretty much done. I could see them maybe getting somebody like maybe like Campaign or whatever, because I think he'll be somebody that comes on for like a cheap, that's like a point, you know, at a point guard spot to give Brunson some minutes. And, you know, I was like, he, not saying he plays like him, but I'm saying like he fits in with the team of like what you sort of need for him. And he's scrappy. I'm not saying he's like a defensive player, but I was like, he's scrappy. And I was like, and they're going to have to figure out their center position, because I was like, it seemed like they want to keep Hartenstein, but that was like, to me, they would have to get rid of Robinson. Other than that, they figured out that spot. Then the Knicks are golden, and they pretty much top team. So, without further ado, let's talk about the East team, the Pacers. I don't really know what they could really do, to be honest. I think they sort of really have their squad, and I think you're really just going to hope for improvement from Haliburton and him staying healthy. Nembhard showed you what he could do in the playoffs. I was like, Mathurin didn't play, so I think you sort of getting a big run out of him. I was like, Obi Toppin, like, he might be gone, but he played so well for them and for before they got Pascal Siakam, and once they did, I was like, I don't know if TJ is a free agent or not either, and that's the case, he might be gone. But I was like, they might try to keep him. They got a bunch of, because to be honest, they don't really have any big money on the books except for like Turner and Siakam. So they could bring him back. He's the Indiana type of player. He's scrappy, you know, all this stuff. He played well when Haliburton wasn't there. I could see him coming back, and they might lose Toppin. But I was like, you could probably fill that spot in. I was like, you don't have nobody that's that athletic, but I was like, Obi is somebody, and I'm like, he'll get burned with somebody. I was like, he's a really good player. I just don't know the market for, like, these type of players, especially with all this money issues and stuff like that. The Cavs, Donovan Mitchell, really, to be honest, I was like, until you figure that out, I was like, I don't know what other moves you really want to do. I was like, maybe Jared Allen somewhere else, but I was like, I don't know if you want to take that risk if you don't know what you're going to get from Donovan Mitchell, to be honest. And I think they're sort of in purgatory right now. And look, their team is good enough to be basically top four in the East. So you might just stand pack and just see how that rolls. I was like, there's nothing here. Cause I was like, I was like between Mitchell, Garland, and Allen is your real money maker. Cause I was like, and you paid through some money last year, but I was like, I don't know if you would like do like a Tobias Harris. Like Tobias Harris on this team, I don't think that would be bad at all. I was like, him at the three, at the four, certain lineups. I was like, the pressure's not on him to be the second, third. You know, I was like, I think that would be really good for this type of team. Yeah, they're just going to figure that out with that. The Magic, I was like, rumors of like Klay Thompson, I think that'd be a really solid type of pick. I was like, I don't think Tyus Jones would be bad. Kind of like he could shoot three, run the point. They really do need 3-point shooting though. So, you know, I was like, some of these names is going to be redundant of like 3-point shooters. Whereas like Buddy Hill or maybe like a Clarkson or things like that. Yeah, I was like, that's what they need. I was like, who's ever really like out there. But to me, I guess you're going to have to spend the money because they don't really have any money tied up into anybody. So that's why Klay Thompson is not a bad choice for any of them. But I was like, maybe like a Luke Kennard. I was like, he might be the, you know, cheap, solid option for them as well in a lot of these situations that you could sort of like be like, okay, if they could get like Kevin Herter from the Kings, I was like, I don't think that'd be a bad thing either. The Bucks, they're sort of pigeonholed. Like a lot of their stuff is really about can they trade with anybody to make any move. That's their sort of situation. Malik Beasley is going to basically test ratings, and it's like, okay, fine. It's like, all right. I was like, they really need to shore up that second guard spot. I was like, don't get me wrong. I was like, I think it'd be cool if, say, for instance, they was able to somehow like get rid of Chris Middleton and they got DeMar DeRozan. I was like, kind of like, Chris Middleton's not over here spacing the floor like that crazy either. I would like the way he get his shots, but I'm like, he's not as hurt at DeRozan, where like DeRozan's like pretty much healthy, same type of dude, constantly there. I think would have the, I would like make good clutch buckets along with Dame, and you got, yeah, I was like, I would like something like that. I know that's like not going to be something that could really happen. I was like, maybe you could get, I was like, Malik Beasley, switch him out with Buddy Hield. I know I done said his name like 45,000 times. And it's just because I'm like, okay, there's just not that many three-point shooters really available out here in that type of way. I was like, they're all either locked up or they're all like marginally good enough to be on a team kind of thing. Oh, I will say, with them going back to the Magic, that somebody, I was like, if they got like Anthony Simons from the Blazers, I was like, combo guard, you already got Suggs, I could play the one or the two. Simons can technically play one or the two. I was like, more of a scorer. I was like, can shoot the three. I was like, I don't think that'd be bad. But yeah, I was like, now going back to the Bucks, I was like, see, somebody like Isaiah Joe that can shoot the ball. I was like, yeah, but he's small that I'm like, I don't necessarily know about that. They're not gonna have the money to get KCP, which would be a great hell of fit for them. I was like, everybody else is either too small to really have with Dame, because you need a big guard there. That's why, like, Gary Harris, I was like, he's 6'4", but I was like, he's a lot bigger to play with Dame, and you can have him in the backcourt and not really, like, lose too much there. I was like, see, the problem is, I'm thinking, Bruce Brown, but I'm like, I feel like he's just going to clog up in some spaces as well. I was like, maybe you go cheap, man, you do, like, Nicholas Batum here. I was like, tall enough to basically overshadow. He could still play defense, shoot threes. I was like, cheap option. Maybe you do something like that. I don't know if it will work, but like Tim Hardaway Jr. I'm just trying to think of like who you can get that's like good enough or better than what you had at the same time. And I was like, Tim Hardaway Jr. is, I think, good enough to basically be in the backcourt with Dame Lillard. He doesn't have to be, he sort of has to be a little bit with the team. But anyway, boggling down too much on that. And they're not going to be able to get Klay, and I think that would be a good fit. They're just sort of hard on spots to me of like, who can you get and who is old enough, because you're not going to really get any of these young players because the money don't match and all that other type of stuff. So that's difficult in that situation. Maybe they could get the person they were originally supposed to get in Bogey from Atlanta. That's somebody that the Bucks, I was like, could also get two that could shoot three. Because remember, they were supposed to have him. And to be honest, I think if they had him, I think they probably would have won a couple more championships. Because he's not, I know everybody, it sounds like I'm talking about, like, you know, great player, but it's like, Yeah, but I'm like, he's another scoring officer. He could shoot three. Then it's like you already had Drew Holiday, Chris Miller. Anyway, we're going on to a little bit of future past type of thing. But I think he'd be a good pickup for them that they might be able to get. I just think that Pat Connaughton, I was like, I was like, he's not a bad player. I was like, he's a decent player. It's just sort of weird why he's just been around them for the longest time. I don't know. Like, is he a fan favorite, like T.J. McConnell in Indiana? Is he like that type of guy where it's like he's just synonymous with the roster, so you keep him? I don't know. Like, Alex Caruso would have been great if they would have did that trade for him, but they didn't. Anyway, for the West, I was like, let's go with the Nuggets, because I think they're pretty much easy of like, I think they're really sort of in a stank spot, just because I was like, I think they're gonna lose KCP. Then you at that point, I was like, they're the way they sort of want to be with their money and stuff, and they didn't keep it together their last team. I'm like, okay, so does that mean Chris Braun just steps in the spot, and then you just sort of take off from there? Do you try to see what you can get from Michael Porter Jr.? I was like, I don't know what the trade market for that guy will be at all. That's worth a damn. So, but I think they're just gonna go the rookie route, to be honest with that. I was like, who they could probably snag. I was like, see, the problem is that like whoever they snag is not gonna give you what KCP does or whatever. It's just because he gave you 3-point shooting defense. In a way that I was like, I think you're getting one of those from somebody that you might be able to get. The Wolves, I think they need another scorer. I was like, I know they drafted the guy, but hey, rookies, there's no telling. So maybe if you're somebody like, and then don't get me wrong, N'Keal Alexander Walker showed that he could do more, but maybe you get somebody like Jordan Clarkson if he's available. You get like Isaiah Joe, and I was like, small guard, but I was like, he could shoot the ball, spread the ball out a lot more. I was like, God, I was like, this team, they became stagnant. At times, I was like, because the thing is, like, you sort of need more, another guard, another wing type of player, just because it's like, you got your, from McDaniels to Reed, Cat, and Gobert, you got your forward type of spots ready to go. Then they're going to lose Kyle Anderson, and I was like, that's not going to really hurt them in the same amount. So I was like, that's where they need to sort of be looking for their type of stuff, in that guard sort of area. Clippers, they're just stuck. You're just going to have to see what PG does. I was like, if you lose them for nothing, then you lose them for nothing. Their money's so tight that they're just not going to be. Now, if you also lost him and James Harden, without doubt, but I was like, to me, they're just stuck. They're just at the whim of whatever Paul George wants to do. I don't have too much for them. The Thunder, I think they did a good job of basically trading one of their younger assets to basically get a veteran that plays their ball, but also you guaranteed to know what you're getting from him. I think they just need to get a big man. That doesn't mean that they need to get somebody to replace Chet at the five, and where Chet is like at the four now. But if you can do that on occasion, because I was like, if they would have matched up against the Nuggets, how's that gonna go? If they would have matched up against, I think Minnesota, I think that would have got them, just because it's like, yeah, just put them on Rudy Gobert, and it's like, okay, cool, but what do you do when it's their turn on offense? So I was like, I think they need to get a big dude, whether it's like Precious Achiuwa because he's young like that. I was like, knowing them, they would probably just. I was like, nah, they wouldn't get Obi Toppin because they don't want to pay the money for that in the same way like you pay our president too. I said something about like Andre Drummond or whatever, where it's like a dude that's not going to be, Precious, I think, is going to try to want to see if he could start. Jonas Valanciunas might think he could start, so it's like that. Those might be difficult. Whereas like Andre Drummond, been around the league a long time. He's still hella young, but I think that because he had to deal with the Bulls, the 76ers, I think he would be fine with accepting a bench role. And in the West, where you need to play Jokic and stuff like that, he's a big ass body to bang and play, I think. But he also is athletic enough to play with Dallas and their big man, or play Minnesota, and they're big dudes. I think that he wouldn't cost crazy nothing. He's young enough, but also a vet that I think it wouldn't be too bad of a spot. And he played with Caruso, so hey, they know each other. You know, maybe they like brothers. I don't know. So then I was like, so the Suns, I think they should learn from our main champion this on the western side of the Mavs, and find a player on the fringes. And I was like, I saved the Mavs for last, but with the Suns, I think they should go ahead and find out who they can snag up that's like a reclamation project, like Dante Exum, a guy that has potential but never stuck on a team like Derrick Jones. But you also gonna have to find these dudes who are kind of like on the cheap and stuff like that. They need to try and shop with some of those bottom team I was talking about. See who the Pistons want to give up. Maybe they want to give up somebody like Stewart or something like that. I was like, maybe you can go back and revenge the Bridges from the Hornets. I was like, the Nets got. And I know they already made the trade with Kevin Durant, but I was like, I think they also got Royce O'Neal from them, so I was like, maybe we get Dorian Finney-Smith from them, which Dorian Finney-Smith would be good on the Bucks, but I was like, you know, I'm like, see who you can call about some of these guys or whatever. I was like, you got Ufis Nurkic, and I was like, you could find like two or three players probably for about that same price that you get for him. That's what they need to do. Maybe I was like, maybe you try to snag. I mean, I know, and I'm just spitballing people because I know the money is making it difficult. But maybe you get a Colin Sexton from Utah. Maybe they're not asking for a lot. Maybe Talen Horton Tucker is just gonna be like, oh, okay, I'll come to Phoenix for a shorter price or whatever. You sort of just need bodies, and you just sort of need to see who's at the bargain bins of stuff. To be honest, that's why I thought like they might actually draft Bronny, to be honest. Then you got the Mavs, and I don't know if they're gonna be able to keep Derrick Jones. Maybe Derrick Jones is like, hey, I'll take a little bit more off the top to stay with this squad, just because, like I said, like to be honest, Derrick Jones. I know I didn't say it in the last video, but Derrick Jones to the 76ers. KCP, Derrick Jones. I'm just saying. That's just me. I think they need another score. Kind of like, Jaden was like, look like a little young at this. I was like, not saying you get rid of him, but he's a little young at this. Tim Hardaway Jr., I think it's time to go for him. He's too streaky. Keep Exum. I was like, you'd be able to bring him back. I was like, go ahead and keep Kleber. He got hurt, and I think that sort of threw off of some of his momentum. You got PJ. I was like, I don't think I would love a world where they could get like Jimmy Butler. It's really gonna be weird because you're gonna see a lot of things where I feel like they lose their player. A lot of teams gonna lose their player. Because that player might want a lot of money from them, but then they get somebody else at that same price. And by that, I was going to say, I brought him up several times before, where like Caleb Martin, I was like, he's Derrick Jones, that where he plays defense. He's not a high flyer like that, but he can shoot the ball as well, too. I'm like, watch, they somehow like get him for like $5 million difference in Derrick Jones. But they just need to just, I was like, Jordan Clarkson might be a little bit out there range. I don't know how the money's tied up, but if I'm Dallas, I try to swing big. I try to see if I can get Jimmy Butler. Not gonna lie. I was like, Miles Bridges. That's where I would try to do if I'm Dallas. I'm trying to be on that be like, yo, screw it. Let's go all in. I know Jimmy Butler might be a little bit of a hard sell. I think Jason Kidd wouldn't be bad with Jimmy Butler. I think he might get Luka's ass where he needs to go or whatever. Or in some of those moments, I was like, he would have had Luka ready to go. They both going to be hothead at each other. But you could be hothead. Like, y'all playing sports. Just y'all could be hotheads. Y'all don't got to be like buddy-buddy like that. Kyrie there to burn some damn sage and calm y'all down. But yeah, I was like, that's what I think the Mavs got to do something like that. They could probably get like a Malik Beasley at a pretty much of a cheap cost or whatever. I was like, I'm trying to think like Markelle Fultz might not be bad. I was like, somebody to attack the rim, you could know the scoring you're going to get from him, kind of thing. Yeah, well, it wouldn't be too bad. Anyway, that's where I think all these teams at so far in all season, where they need to do maybe something to pick up people they need to get, whatnot. Let me know what you think for some of these championship squads. Till then, peace. I'm out.